Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and it's what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer. I've always had a vivid imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards. So yes, it began with a dream. Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late, desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse. For some urgent reason, I couldn't remember. I'd been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there. I'd seen the hitchhiker too late. He was dead. I was convinced they'd put me in jail and I would never see Alice again. Suddenly, his body was gone. I was in shock from the crash. I could hardly stand my feet.
Hello and welcome to my channel again, and this is Alan Wake. And let's get into it. No, of course not reversing. You can change your setting, blah blah, okay. Use VSD to walk, shift to sprint. I already tested, I think everything is working fine as I want and intend.
I had to go to the lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me there.
Not sure why I cannot change my shoulder camera yet. Wait a minute. Shoulder camera. Oh, it's tab. Okay, it's tab. I think I will. Wait a minute. Reload battery focus. I should exit this mini game. I think I'm ready? Yeah.
You don't even recognize me, do you, Ryder? You think you're God? You think you can just make up stuff? Play with people's lives and kill them with your finger adds to the drama. You're in this story now, and I'll make you suffer.
Yeah, I'm not gonna hear you, my man. Let's go.
You missed your deadline!
You can duck enemy attack.
You can't stop me!
I realized that the hitchhiker was a character from the story I'd been working on.
How does it feel to die by the hands of your own creation?
Oh, yeah, I'm not dodging that.
Thank you.
I was trapped. There was no way out. The cabin was a death trap. I had to get out.
Light. Oh, who is that? Jesus? Is that you?
You are hurt. You should go into the light. You are only safe there.
Safe haven.
Well done. I have something important to tell you. It goes like this. For he did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No.
Follow my light.
To the port I've been. Somewhere.
I entered your dream to teach you. The darkness is dangerous. It's sleeping now. When it feels you coming, it will wake up. There's no time. I can only show you the most important thing. The hitchhiker has been taken over by the dark presence. You can't hurt him now. The darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light.
Thank you.
Turn your flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away. You did it. Now the darkness no longer protects him, but it's still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy. Here, take the gun.
Oh, goddamn. Jesus. I love that. Gun from Jesus.
Good. You've done well. Remember what I've taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
There you go.
In the nightmare, a terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
Let me guess, I have to go there. Give me up. Let's go.
You made me this way, and now I'm gonna kill you.
There's two of them. Let's fight this guy. Oh, okay. Then that again. Oh, wait, I forgot to pick a flare. Because in my first playthrough, when I was checking stuff, I remember that. Yeah, there's a flare here.
You're dead. Just like me.
Okay, we are almost there. What? Oh, where did you kill me from? Such a relentless guy. Love your content. Everyone loves people like this. Dedicated job.
I can keep this up forever!
What? Where did that even come from? Oh god
Baby, just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here.
Right, false. I think we heard about it in control. But it's about in the wait. I come to right false. So from what we heard in control.
Let's act like we're on vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman there. Okay. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
Okay.
Sure. I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy. Moments before he got eaten by a bear. Hi.
Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deerfest, huh? Did you hear that, honey?
You have a lovely wife. If you don't mind me saying, I'm Pat Main, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, thank you.
I'm Alan Wake.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I could get an interview?
Look, Mr. Main, I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be discreet. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
Thank you. So from what we heard, there's some interviewee that happened here. Was an adult event. But I'm not sure what about it. Said that it's about Alan Wake, book.
Very nice. I got a couple of really good ones. And I see you made a friend. That's cute.
Right. Yeah?
Hey, bestseller. How's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah. We just got here.
Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry, we're fine.
Great. Just want to make sure you can relax and recharge. So, how is the place? Has it gotten your creative juices flowing?
Barry, We're just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay. And you call me if there's a problem, okay? Okay. Just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
You know he's going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you too.
Ah!
Alan, we're here. Come on, let's get back to the car.
Okay. Old engine is acting up.
We need to stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord, a Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us. I'll go fill her up or you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes.
Sure.
Alan, thank you for coming here with me.
I love you too. Go on. I'll promise to behave.
You seem like an easily annoying person.
I'd forgotten there were still places like this. Towns where everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to the Oh Dear Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan Wake. Oh, God! I am your biggest fan. I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose.
Rose, I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment.
I can't believe it. I've got all of your books. I got the cutout from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
And you keep it here. Well, okay. Good for you.
Here's your phone, man. There you go, there you go. What's that guy doing there?
Try the coffee. Just don't blame me when you fall in love, because it'll break your heart when you have to leave.
Rusty here is no longer human. Nothing but black coffee under a thin layer of skin.
Yeah, that makes two of us.
Do me a favor, Sonny. I could really use a tune right now. Coconut, number 6 in the jukebox. I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation.
Number six. Are you serious? Coconut again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable.
It does that. Get stuck. Yeah, you need to give it a good solid whack. You put
nice.
The lime in the coconut, drink them both up. Now that's what I'm talking about, yes!
Chilling.
This is it.
What time
I've
is
died
it?
And gone to hell.
Waking up. What's this guy doing? Stuff? Are you okay? Chilling. Like creepy guy. I want. What are you, Michael? Can I drink my coffee, please? I want to drink my coffee. In real life, I hate coffee. You know how that other thing? Yes, I hate it. Because I have to investigate it.
Don't go in there, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am. I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stuckey, to get the key and get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Overeager fans always did.
I think it's okay. Hello.
Hello? Mr. Stuckey?
Yeah, Mr. Stuckey is stuck.
Carl couldn't make it. Unfortunately, he was taken ill. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife. I insist.
Thanks.
Thank you. Thank you, lady. Thank you.
Cauldron Lake is a special place. Very inspiring.
It sure is. It sure is. Ma'am, do you,
you
know
got
that
lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark. This really ought to be fixed. And then I must remind Sarah to change the lights at the station. It's been too long already.
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Are you all right?
Splendid, splendid! Damn hernia. It swells up like a balloon if I lift anything heavier than a spoon. Yeah. Splendid, splendid. It's been a long time, Tom. Good to see you.
Hey, you wouldn't happen to have a bottle on you, would you, Tom?
I wish.
They seem like
they're local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Well, I'm gonna. Yeah, I'm gonna.
Bye, Mr. Wake.
See ya.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
Hey, wait! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
Oh, no. Where did I go, then?
That diner was a real nut house.
Can you believe this place? This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home. Okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Batman here on PBFF.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
And now the weather. It's gonna be a clear night, so you folks in the big city might want to look up every once in a while, see those stars winking down at you. It gets pretty dark out here, but they'll light your way.
Where am I alive? Are you sure this is a place?
Wow. It's gorgeous, Alan.
It's something, all right.
I'm glad you like it.
Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
I know. I'm okay.
Alice had a phobia. The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
Hello, Annabelle. Let's do that for her then. I guess. Flash in the dark. But it's not as much as scared of a tight place for me. That is really bad.
Come on, here we go. Let's take a look inside.
Let me look around the cabin first. Generator?
An old generator had been connected to the power cable.
Oh, that door is not open. Nice one. Such a...
Good work, honey. I'll freshen up a bit and start settling in.
Okay.
Okay. I'll look around a bit.
Sure thing. Have fun.
It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work. I thought we could be happy here.
Damn. Fuck. I have a good feeling and bad feeling of the fog in the same time. Don't really like it that much, but kinda like it.
Alice? Honey?
A shoebox filled with books by Thomas Zane sat on the shelf. I'd never heard of him before.
Oh, the nightmare begins. Oh, what's this? Coffee.
Alan, I'm upstairs. Oh. I have a surprise for you.
Why is the back door open?
Well, hello there.
I'm not the surprise. It's in the study. Go take a look.
Okay.
Okay.
1970? God, what? I wonder how dark it should be. Is this dark enough? There's one option, nope. Brightness. Oh my god, I don't see. Easily visible, values are not visible. So it should be like this? Are you kidding me? God damn!
Surprise!
Alice? What is this?
I guess I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past-
Damn, Alice, you- Everyone keeps-
Hey, just hear me out! There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Maybe so now you want to get me committed?
No! It's not like that. That's not... Alan? Alan?
I don't! Just don't! I don't want to hear it! God damn it, Alice! God damn it!
I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through.
I think he must be like,
damn it,
you know.
Alice?
I think he must. Keep his anger for a long time.
All the lights were out.
Alan!
Alan! Where are you? Help!
Alice, I'm coming! It's all right, I'm coming!
Help!
What the hell?
Alan! Help me!
Oh no!
Keep going, Alice. Wake up,
Alice.
Waking up in the crashed car felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice. The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot.
What even is happening here? Goddamn.
Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma, by a Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either. The gas station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
Well, here go my car. Here go all my lifespan.
Hello?
Oh, it's you again, Jesus.
Hello? Is someone there?
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started. I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night.
Oh, that's what's gonna happen, is it? Oh, well.
Departure by Alan Wake. The man turned to face me. His face was covered in shadows. It was hard to make him out in the darkness of the forest that surrounded us, but the axe he lifted was plain to see. It glistened with the blood of his victim. He grinned madly. The shadows were alive, distorting his features. It was a scene from a nightmare, but I was awake.
Alan Wake has awakened. Good thing that I don't have to lead everything. I love it.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
The lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
Anybody there? Please.
Hey! Hey, you!
Phil!
There's been an accident. I need help.
Deposit.
Listen, I need to...
Premium cabins for rent in...
Nightfall!
Oh, hell.
Carl Stuckey.
Pleased
to meet you. Non-refundable
reservation.
Deposit required. Fair and square.
Oh. That's good, isn't it?
Carl Stuckey! Please don't you.
The Taken stood before me. It was impossible to focus on it, as if it stood in a blind spot caused by a brain tumor and eye disease. It was bleeding shadows like ink underwater, like a cloud of blood from a shark bite. I was terrified. I squeezed the flashlight like my life depended on it, willing it to stop coming any closer. Suddenly something gave, and the light seemed to shine brighter.
Premium!
This interview seems to be super lethal.
It's the latest thing!
Two
birds?
Incontestably
proven health!
Benefits.
I'm not sure how it did that in a dodge.
Cholesterol levels! Great!
I had to figure a way out of this. Any second now, and Stuckey would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
Engineizer. Engineizer? Is that the brand? Can't remember, but it's good. Batteries. did it get sponsored by Engineizer?
Trying.
It's
yes.
The latest.
Right Fall Sheriff Station. Help me out.
Testimony.
Hello? Hello?
Ruben! Help. Let you.
Shoot!
The spirit.
kind of hit this is? Jesus Christ!
There were more of them.
Oh my God! It's really hard to dodge. I need to get used to it.
I'd never fired a gun outside a shooting range, and now I just killed someone, or something. There were no bodies. They just disappeared. If I was dreaming, it felt real enough to make me sick. The Dark Forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
Oh, so this interview is a bit intense or savage or I don't know, crazy, insane. So what I'm getting from this is Alan Wake has power to cleanse his or his prediction by his flashlight. Right? A lot. Where do I go? Oh, that way. Hello. Clear? I shouldn't think that. Is that lady again?
What the hell was that? When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water. Barry Wheeler was bouncing off the walls. He jumped on a plane after his calls were ignored by both Al and Alice for several days. It could mean that they were both on a second honeymoon, but Barry didn't buy it. Al had been way too unstable for that, not sleeping, messed up. Barry had years of experience dealing with Alan Wake, and he couldn't ignore it. Something was wrong. Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking me.
I don't think that's Stucky anymore. Oh my God, I'm stuck between logs. your suit.
Token! Who's not answered this? Occupation!
Logging ahead. Okay.
The staircase was broken. I had to make my way up some other way. There was no power. There was bound to be a generator somewhere at the logging site.
I think I can see it. I think I just saw it actually. It's on the line left. There's coffee there. Yeah. Boom! Ow.
With all this forestry equipment around, there had to be something I could use to reach the top. I heard them before I saw them, swooping down from the sky and screeching as they came. I spun around just as the cloud was upon me. For an instant, I stared into 100 dead eyes, black pearls glittering in the darkness. I raised the flashlight and the swarm exploded like fireworks. Feathers burned, turned into ash. I couldn't hear my scream above theirs.
I love the word that they're using in this one. Very creative. Woo! Shotgun. Oh, they're two bullets. Yeah, I'm not gonna use that. That's for now, though. She's like a dark in the night. Oh! Okay. Dead by daylight. Nice! Not sure what do I have to do with it yet, but I think I have to bring it. No, I cannot bring it too. Oh, okay, it's like a bitch. Okay, wait. Oops. I thought I could pass that.
I was just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night. I know most of you are probably in your beds by now, but if you're still up and around, take a moment. Step outside for a spell and breathe in deep. The weather is absolutely still. The sky is crystal clear. It's like the forest is quietly breathing along with you. As you listeners know, I'm a night owl, and it's on nights like this I wish I wasn't cooped up in the studio. Makes an old man like me wish I could just roam wild. But here I am, and don't keep you company all night long if I weren't. It looks like I'm not the only one staying up late. Caller, you're on the air.
Hey, Pat, it's Maurice Horton.
Hello, Maurice. What are you up to?
Well, I was just taking Toby on his walkies.
Oh, isn't it beautiful out there?
Sure, but Pat, the reason I called is that Toby heard something rustling undergrowth and took off after it, and I couldn't find it.
Probably a rabbit.
Sure. Toby loves rabbits.
Well, sure.
Anyway, I figured that, you know, if anyone runs into Toby, they could grab him. My number's on his collar.
And Toby's a friendly dog?
Oh, Toby loves people. Usually he comes back, but we were pretty far from home, and it sounds like he went pretty wild there. Great dog, but he's just too dumb for his own good.
Well, Maurice, it's out there now. Hope Toby comes home soon.
Yeah, thanks, Pat.
You have a good night now.
Okay. Toby Fox. Toby the Fox. Toby the Dog.
At first, I kept finding the pages as if by accident. The book I couldn't remember was either a terrible and true prophecy, or an act of creation that had rewritten the world. I began to hunt the pages feverishly, for they held the answer to the mystery. With it, I could save myself. With it, I could save Alice. The gas station was closer now, its light welcoming in the darkness.
Paul makes the best dogs. State. Belly Burster is the best with no
contest. Monster Dog
is second best. The famous dog is...
Oh my god. Okay, time to... A little bit too much. They're so fast too. I thought I would get two with one, but guess not. Okay, starting to get used to it. Very nice. Feel very good. Go! It surely couldn't be that way, right? Family reunion. Oh my god, it's horrible.
I stepped into the gas station's garage. It was dark and quiet. The place was a mess. It looked like someone trashed the place or that there'd been some kind of fight. Light spilled into the room through an open door at the back, and I made my way toward it. Without any warning, I was blinded by a bright light. An old portable TV on the shelf had come alive by itself. Impossibly, I could see myself on the screen, talking like a madman.
Glad I finally found a way.
Eerie hand-painted graffiti was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it.
Dungu.
The cabin on Cauldron Lake? she asked. The sheriff looked at me suspiciously. The early morning light flooded through the office windows. I would probably never have gotten out of the woods alive without her help, but I couldn't tell her the truth of what I'd faced the previous night. She'd think I was lying or crazy. She'd lock me up, and she wouldn't help me find Alice.
Immortality on those who advance it to elevate all of mankind. Newton, Einstein, Sagan, princes among men. But the price for such a legacy is steep indeed. In Night Springs. Tonight's episode, A Quantum Suicide. If our lives are already written, it would take a courageous man to change the script. Having called a press conference, Dr. Barclay Colvin is about to demonstrate that very courage.
Ladies and gentlemen of the press, I am Dr. Barclay Colvin, and I'm glad so many of you could join me here at the Moorcock Institute. Tonight, I'm going to give a practical demonstration of the many worlds interpretation. As you can see, this is a loaded 9mm pistol. It shall be part of a thought experiment. And now, a real experiment, known as a quantum suicide.
Did he say suicide? Is that a real gun? He's kidding, right?
Please, please, stay calm. There is no risk. Observe what occurs when I place the weapon against my own forehead. Now, you might think this round is merely a dud. Not so. Observe the flower pot. And yet, I myself cannot be harmed with this gun. With each pull of the trigger, two new realities branch off. One in which the weapon didn't fire, and one where it did. With my machine here, I have ensured that this reality is always the former. I have bestowed upon myself quantum immortality. Under no circumstances can this gun kill me.
So wait. What you're saying is that every time you pull the trigger, in another reality, you die?
Yes, of course, but that's completely trivial. There's an infinite number of things that could happen at any moment, and they always do happen somewhere. The point is, this one thing did not happen here.
You're insane, Colvin.
Insane? Insane?
Hey, was this thing supposed to be plugged in? I stumbled on it.
You fools! Gaze upon quantum immortality!
Poor Dr. Colvin. Felled by his own hubris or the ignorance of the masses. Perhaps he should have left the crate unopened, the decaying atom unobserved. Curiosity often kills the cat. In Night Springs.
What a wide episode. I want to end this episode first before I go. It's gonna be a long one, but it's already being left behind. I think there's something following me. Imagine how windy it would be to make entire log swing.
Oh no.
Stucky's body vanished, leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come, assuming I'd reach the lights at the gas station alive.
I think these things are like his to take over the body. Because every time that his take over the body and they died, their body disappeared with them. I think it's the same thing. Possibly. Now, how do I go there?
I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice. After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself. Stucky spat on the garage floor and tried to shake the cobwebs from his head. Ever since the couple never showed to pick up the keys, things had been fuzzy. Something, a feeling, caught his attention. Stucky looked up and stared as his brain tried in vain to process the horror before him. He stumbled back, knocking over a can of oil. A black pool spread across the floor while he struggled for a brief moment, then let go as the unrelenting darkness engulfed him. The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
Right. I'll keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her. I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this. It'd been me on the TV, talking crazy. Was I losing my mind?
Yummy. Where's everyone? Surfing, fishing, pie contest, surprise competitions, live music. Deer fest. Just like that guy told me. Phone. Oh!
Bright Falls Sheriff Station.
Oh, thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen, I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
Listen.
We'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
Way bigger than object. Alan Wake.
Her candy-colored clown, and that's it for I intro. Call the Sandman. Tiptoes to my room every night, and just a sprinkle stardust and a whisper.
The end of episode one.
Everything is all right. I close my eyes, then I drift away.
Previously on Alan Wake.
Okay, I think I will.
To Bright Falls with my wife, Alice.
Thank you for coming here with me. I thought maybe you could write here.
I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice.
Now, she's missing.
Alice? Alice?
I woke up behind the wheel of a crashed car. I'm missing a week. I was attacked by shadowy men straight from a nightmare. The sheriff took me to the lake Alice and I had stayed at, but the cabin had disappeared.
Okay, when is it for 2 years ago? What?
Honey, I'm home.
Back here, sweetie. How was it?
Worst weather I've ever seen.
You should put some coffee on. It'll warm you up.
Okay, well, that's it for Alan Wake episode 1. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you didn't find. Don't forget to take care. So, my name is Alfossi. And for today, I'm out.